Hello, welcome to a new episode. Today we'll continue with the topic of the logistic regression. Now it's part 2, forecasting. Forecasting by logistic regression means to calculate the conditional probabilities of the response variable. Usually we train with one data set and then apply the forecast to another data set. Let's do a quick recap of the logistic regression. Let's suppose that we have k independent variables. They are usually denoted as x1, x2, up to xk. Let's suppose that we have one dependent variable, also called the response. It is usually denoted as y. Y can be either 1 or 0. Now suppose that there is a variable s, which couples linearly to the independent variables. By linear coupling, we mean this functional form. We have the independent variables x1, x2, up to xk, of which values are given as data. Then the beta coefficients are multiplied and everything is summed together. There is a so-called logistic function which connects the variable s with the response y. The logistic function gives the probability of the response y having value equal to 1. When we say train the regression model, we mean fitting the beta coefficients with the training data. Now, suppose the situation where new values for the independent variables are given. These new values are denoted as x prime. Also, suppose that we do not know the values of the corresponding dependent variable y prime. Then we can apply the already trained model to calculate the probability of the y prime be equal to 1. This is what we call the forecasting step. The probability that we calculate is a conditional probability because it is conditional on the values of x prime. Okay, now it's time to go through an example on the Excel spreadsheet. We have this Excel file named Example Logistic Regression Forecast. We have the training set with 3 independent variables, x1, x2, and x3. And with one dependent variable y. We have the testing set with the independent variables x1, x2, and x3, which are in fact the x primes. There's no dependent variable y prime. This is a simulated data of student admission records. The variables have the meanings as shown here. We have seen this data in the previous episode, the part 1 of the logistic regression. Now, let's forecast y prime using PrimaXL. We go to the PrimaXL tab, click on it, and bring up its ribbon menu. Then, we click on the arrow under the button named Logistic, and then select Forecast. A menu form appears. This menu form is quite intuitive. At the top, we should specify the data range for the training step. Both x and y should be given. Next, we should specify the data range for the forecasting or testing. Here, we only need the data range for the x. In fact, this would be the x prime. Finally, we should specify where to output the result. Okay, let's just do it. We can click on this small button and bring up the range input form where we can easily select the data range and return. This way, we can fill out all the blanks with the corresponding ranges. Okay, I think we are ready. Now just press the run button. Great! We have the result. We can format the numbers so that they look nicer. Please remember that these numbers represent the probabilities, which should be values between 0 and 1. Finally, a summary. Today, we saw how to forecast using the logistic regression. We had two data sets, one for training and another for forecasting or testing. We saw how easy it is to forecast the response variable using PrimaXL. In the coming episode, we'll push even further. We'll discuss how to interpret the forecast result and how to train and then test using the logistic regression. Excellent! I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Thank you so much. Until next time, bye.